congratulations on the movie.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
For my fans at home, without spoiling anything away, what's your role?
Jeremiah. He's an innocent kid who gets into a situation where Lefty picks him up, and he's read all these diamond novels, and he wants to be like the cowboys that he's actually read.
Nice. Yeah. And were you always a fan of the Western genre?
I mean, I've only watched like a couple Westerns, like one or two, The Magnificent Seven and The Quick and the Dead with Leonardo DiCaprio. But I do think they should be coming back, and I'll be really interested to watch more of them. And I love this one too.
Now, I gotta ask you this. What's it like working with the greats like Bill Pullman and all those guys?
Oh my gosh, it's so great. They're so amazing. They're so passionate about their craft, and I respect it so much, and I want to be just like them when I grow up.
Yes. Oh my God. I'm a huge fan of Sons of Anarchy. Rama,
how are you, buddy?
Dude, you are one of the coolest, badass characters on TV.
I can't argue with that.
So, for my fans at home, without spoiling it away, your role in this film?
I'm the Marshal, Tom Hanna. I'm the kind of good guy, but not really.
Nice. And what's it like working with the greats like Bill Pullman and Peter Fonda and everybody?
Oh, are you kidding me? I this whole movie we shot in 2 months, and I didn't get to know Bill Pullman until the very last frame of the movie, when we jumped in his car and we drove to his ranch and we went on a cattle drive at 6 o'clock in the morning in the mountains of Montana. And I finally got to know Bill, because the whole time we were shooting, he was Lefty Brown.
Dang.
Yeah, it was so cool. You know, how you talk about ending, that's how you end a cowboy movie, just like that. That was very cool.
Last question, sir. Western is far and few in between these days. I mean, what's your favorite Western of all time, if you could pick a couple?
Oh, it's got to be...
Tombstone, maybe?
No, well, Tombstone's great. I love Tombstone, but... Growing up as a kid, it was Magnificent Seven.
Ah, the original one.
The original, yeah. Steve McQueen, all that stuff, yeah. That was my favorite.
We know that we're fans of Bill Pullman. What is it about him that you want to make him as your lead?
I mean, Bill is such a versatile actor. What other actors have the ability to go from playing the President of the United States in Independence Day to a jazz singer living in an illusionary world in a David Lynch movie? To doing, you know, a comedy office at Ellen DeGeneres, like in Mr. Wrong. He has this great range as an actor, yet no matter how ridiculous or strange the character he plays, he always endows them with this real humanity.
So a lot of Westerns over the years, but it's few and far in between nowadays. So why this genre?
Why not this genre, right? Shouldn't you be asking all the other filmmakers who come on this camera, like, hey, why aren't you making more Westerns, man? I mean, it's Westerns. These are cinema at its purest.
Yes.
Everyone should be making Westerns.
And you inspired this more of a like Unforgiven or a Tombstone kind of inspiration?
This is inspired really much by like the old John Ford Westerns, like Rio Bravo and The Man Who Shot Liberty Valance. For me, it's like that Walter Brennan, Gabby Hayes sidekick character who's constantly laughed at throughout the course of the entire movie, yet is the person who's the last line of defense, you know, in the jail with a shotgun. If everything goes bad, he's the guy they're relying on. And that I wanted to find that human being behind that archetype.